Not everything is within our hands to control. In fact, there are precious few things that are actually in our hands to control. Greetings, fellow human. I'm Rose from happyandauthentic.com. And today I would like to talk about why I don't worry about factors outside of my control. Way too many people worry about things that they have absolutely no control over. And I used to be that person, big time. I'd worry so much about things I could do nothing about, but I tried anyway. I'd plan out every little aspect of my life, and I would get seriously worked up about every little thing that didn't go my way. It was very unhealthy and caused me so much stress. When things went wrong, I would just try harder to control even more things, which of course didn't help a bit. Of course, one day I realized that the problem wasn't that I wasn't good enough at controlling things, or that I had to try harder to control things. It was my attitude of thinking that I could control things in the first place. There's so much in life that we have zero say in, like where we're born, what our race is, who our family members are. We can't change any of that, and just like it's pointless to complain about those things, it's just as pointless to focus our energy on other circumstances we have no power over. A lot of us are convinced that we should constantly strive to exert dominance over our circumstances, mainly because the go-getter society we live in has given us the impression that we need to constantly strive to forge our own destiny and grab life by the horns. We're taught to just try harder when we want something and don't get it. And while there's definitely something to be said about having the confidence and determination to go after your dreams, thinking we have the power to change literally anything we want in life encourages manipulation, exploitation, and other unsavory ways of influencing people to do what we want. It can also convince us that if something isn't going our way, it means there's something wrong with us, that we're not good enough, when really, it could just be one of those things we simply can't change. Not everything is within our hands to control. In fact, there are precious few things that are actually in our hands to control. Most of the time, things just happen around us, and all we can do is adjust our actions in response to those things. I used to hate the idea of not having power over things so much that I became a control freak. I micromanaged every little thing in my immediate vicinity and even tried to force those around me to bend to my will. Of course, it didn't work because you can never truly force someone to do what you want if they don't want to. All you can do is either make them wish they did because of how you act when they don't, or they'll just pretend to listen and then do what they want in secret. No one likes being told what to do. So trying to control people is a surefire way to push them out of your life. My controlling behavior was an unhealthy attempt to prevent bad things from happening. But no matter how hard I tried to control things, bad things still sometimes happened. And whether they did or didn't happen, I would worry about them anyway. I'd think about all the things that could possibly go wrong and how awful it would be if they did. And when something did go wrong, I would constantly repeat it in my head and worry about what it meant that it went wrong and how I was gonna deal with it. And I would just roll around in those thoughts for ages. I'd make plans about how I would react in those imaginary scenarios and ended up spending a huge chunk of my life in a constant state of anxiety. But one day, I met someone who never seemed to worry about anything. They seemed so calm and content whenever I spent time with them, even when there was a chance things could go horribly wrong. This person knew that worrying didn't do anything to take away future trouble. All it did was take away present peace. They taught me that when you spend all that time thinking about what might or might not happen, you end up ignoring or completely missing what's actually going on in the moment. The irony was that by focusing on future possibilities, I was actually causing a lot of the bad things that I was imagining to come about because I wasn't taking simple steps in the present that could have mitigated them. Basically, this person taught me that there's a big difference between worrying about things and preparing for things. I used to claim that I was just being realistic, and if I didn't worry, then I wouldn't be ready for the bad things that might happen. But it didn't take a genius to realize that the more I worried about things, the less likely I was to actually take concrete steps that would lessen the chance of those things coming to pass. This simple realization showed me that I can't control everything that happens to me, but I can control how I respond to things. And that's way more important. Stress only comes from thinking about things, not from doing things. If I'm acting and being present in my action, then I'm not thinking, which means I'm not worrying. And when I'm not worrying, I have the clarity to act in ways that really make a difference in my life. Worrying was such a misuse of my creative energy and intellect. So instead of imagining the worst, I now just accept whatever the situation is and respond to it as mindfully as I can. Of course, when the situation is emotional, that can be really hard to do. So I do mess up a lot, but I try my best to bring myself back to the present whenever I catch my attention drifting. It helps when other people know what my intention is and can hold me accountable to that intention. Just a gentle reminder here and there to be more present is all it takes to keep me from worrying more than I need to. Worrying is basically dwelling on the past or imagining the future. The past is already done and can't hurt you anymore. And that future you're imagining may never come. Neither of those things can happen when your attention is on the here and now. So that's really how I stop myself from worrying. I try to be here now, which is to say, be present and aware in the moment. I know that most people worry because it helps them regain control of a situation in which they feel powerless. It's a coping mechanism. We don't worry when we think we're in control. What took me a while to realize was that I never actually have control over any situation. Not in the way I used to think. Things can always go wrong and things can always not go according to plan. So even when I think I'm in control, I'm not. The only reason why I don't worry in those situations is because of how I think. The situation is exactly the same. So why not just change how I think in the other, more stressful situations too? Then I don't have to actually figure out a way to have more power over my circumstances. Hopefully you understand my point here. There are countless things that we could worry about, but only a small number of things that we can control. You can't change what others say, do, or think. You can't decide how other people's actions or random events affect you. What you can do is decide how you think, how you act. Your attitude and your actions are where all your power lies, and they can help you make the most out of every opportunity that comes your way. They can help you create opportunities out of every situation that you find yourself in, but only if you accept the things that you can't change. So you'll have more energy left over for the things that you can change. Hopefully I was clear about this. I do know that I was a little bit vague at points, so if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments below, and I'd be more than happy to answer them. If you found this information useful, or you think someone else will, please share it and give it a like. If you enjoy videos like this, then feel free to subscribe. And if you want to be notified whenever I come out with a new video, ring the bell. Otherwise, you can just manually check out my channel every Sunday, which is when I come out with a new video. I make secret monthly videos and host live Q&As over on Patreon, so if you're interested in that, head on over there. There's a link in the description and a button at the end. If you'd like to hire me as a coach, go to happyandauthentic.com. Your first session will be free, so we can just get to know each other. Whatever you decide, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you when I see you. And now it's time to thank my patrons, Eric Gindes, Don Rivers, Lizmar Santiago, and Tanya Danilenko. Thank you so much, you guys. You really humble me. The fact that you're still here amazes me, but I am so grateful. Thank you.